Hello everyone and welcome back to a brand new episode. In this episode I'm going to be showing you what I think are the top 5 or more things to do each day in membership. So I'm going to go day 1, day 2, day 3 and I'm going to tell you what you should have achieved by the end of day 1, day 2, day 3. And I'll put the levels up and all that jazz, so I'll try and make it, you know, as easy to follow as possible. So let's just get straight into the video. Right, the first thing you want to do is get yourself a house. It only costs 1k and you need to go to Falador and buy a house from this geezer right here. Once you've got a house, you can now use a house teleport to Rimington, and I'd suggest going to World 330 and using someone else's house who's got 99 construction. 330 is a pretty popular world, so you might not be able to get in there, but just keep on trying. Use the advertisement and look for someone's house and enter it. The four main things you want to use in someone's house is the rejuvenation pool, which brings all your stats back to full. The gilded altar, which is a really fast way to train prayer. There is also a jewelry box, which will give you all the teleports around the game on the jewelry items, and then there is a teleport nexus which will give you all the other teleports around the game, so it's really, really useful. So the next thing that we're going to do is a load of quests. Yay! The first quest you want to do is Witch's House to get the health, the HP, XP, and then you want to go on to do the Tree Gnome Village to get some attack XP, and then after that you want to do Fight Arena to get some more attack XP and a little bit of Thieving XP, and then you want to get 10 Fletching. You can do this by just making arrow shafts or headless arrows. It should literally take about 2 minutes, and then you want to do Tourist Trap after that, and it's important that you use the XP lamps at the end on agility. After that, we are going to do Grand Tree to get some more agility XP and attack XP. And then after that, you want to do Waterfall Quest to get some strength and attack XP. After all these quests, your stats should look a bit like this. I've based these stats on my previous video on what you need to do before you get to members. Okay, that's it for day one. So if you've still got time, that should have taken you around 2 to 3 hours. You can either go thieving at Ardoin and get your thieving level up. You can thieve wherever you want. You can pick pockets or you can thieve at the cake stalls. You can also do some fishing at Barbarian Fishing, which gives you strength and agility XP as well. So that's pretty useful. But what I would recommend is going to Wintertod using a games necklace and doing a few games of Wintertod. Obviously look up a guide for this, but a quick overview is that you basically just hack away at these roots and chuck the logs into the fire to kill the Wintertod boss. You can get damaged, so take some food. I'd recommend jugs of wine because they're super cheap, but you also get a bit of loot at the end, so it's a pretty fun mini boss all in all. Obviously there's a lot of other things you can do. You can go and explore, but you know, do what you want with the spare time. This is your free time, okay? Day 2. Today we're going to be doing quests again. Bear with me. We unlock quite a few things with these quests, so let's just get to it. First quest we're going to do is Priest in Peril, which unlocks you Mauritania, which is very important in the game. Then we are going to do Merlin's Crystal. This is a nice easy 6 quest points, but that's about it. But then after we've done Merlin's Crystal, we can do Holy Grail, which gives you a lot of prayer XP and defense experience. Next, we're going to do Client of Kurend to unlock the Island of Kurend, which is also very important. After that, we're going to do the Natural History Quiz, which is very easy. Look up a guide. You just need to go in the basement of Varrock Museum, talk to the guide at the entrance, and basically just answer the questions about each of the showcases. After that, we're going to do Lost City of Zanaris to unlock the fairy realm. By the end of day 2, this is what your stats should look like. Now on day 2 you can do whatever you want again, but I would suggest to start doing agility. You want to get this done pretty early and get some Marks of Grace, because that unlocks the outfit Graceful, which is extremely useful throughout the game. I basically wear it all the time unless I'm doing combat, so it is a very useful item. And because we have done client of Karend. We can now go train combat if you wish. On day 5, the video is going to split. It's going to be one route is going to be combat, and then the other route is going to be skills. So you can decide on day 5 which one you want to pursue. They both have their pros and cons, but I'll get to that later in the video. The training method for training combat is using the sand crabs south, at the very south point of Karend Island. These are very useful because they're extremely AFK and they have quite a lot of hit points, so you can AFK and get quite a lot of experience at the same time. Okay, for day 3, the first thing we want to do is do the Dwarf Cannon quest to get the Dwarf Cannon. This is a very useful item to use for Slayer and to train range, but we'll get to that later in the video. I wouldn't recommend using it straight away because it is pretty expensive to use. After that, we want to do the Giant Dwarf quest. This quest will unlock our first moneymaker, but we'll get to that later in the video. The first moneymaker is Blast Furnace, but we need a few other requirements to make actual decent money from that. After that, you can do Druidic Ritual to unlock the Herbalore skill, and then do Plague City to unlock the Ardoin Teleport. After that, you want to get 10 Herbalore, and then you want to get 25 Thieving, so that we can do the quest Dig Site. Doing Dig Site quest will give us a lot of early game mining experience. By the end of day 3, your stats should look something like this. Day 4, we're going to do a few more quests. The first quest we want to do is the Lost Tribe, where you'll get a little bit of mining experience. Then we're going to do Death to the Dorgushan, which is a prerequisite for the next quest, Another Slice of Ham. This quest is fairly important because it gives you the Ancient Mace. Now you can use this item special attack to recharge your prayer, which is very important when you're using prayer to kill monsters. A quick tip, you can also use the Ancient Mace on a punch bag or whatever you call them to increase your prayer past its maximum level. After this, you can either power mine to level 41 mining, and then after that you want to do Soulsbane. We're doing some of these quests to do the Varrok Diaries. At the end of day 4, your stats should look something like this. Day 5. So this is where the grind begins, basically, and this is where you need to decide whether you're going to go down the combat route or you're going to go down the skills route. I'll explain the difference. Okay, so what I'd recommend if you're struggling for money, you know, if you're a bit worried about getting your next bond, maybe you've only got about 200k in the bank, then I would go down the skills route because it is a guaranteed moneymaker, the path that we're going to go down, and you can get at least 500k per hour going down this route. But it is skilling, so it's fairly boring to get, but once you've unlocked that moneymaker, you can do whatever you want. The combat route is basically working towards Slayer. I would do this if you're fairly confident at making money and you've already got quite a lot of money in the bank and you're not too worried about making your next bond. So how do we get about going down each route? What I'm going to do is do the skill route first and then I'll do the combat route second. So on day 5, you want to go to the Motherlode mine and use your best pickaxe, and you want to mine. The goal is to mine 100 nuggets from Motherlode Mine. I'd recommend you look up a guide to how to do Motherlode Mine, but it's fairly simple. A quick overview is you just mine the pay dirt, stick it into this hopper, let it get cleaned, and then collect the ore at the end. Every now and again, you'll get a nugget with the ore. By the end of day 5, if you've chosen the skill route, your levels should look something like this. The combat route, what you want to do is go to the sand crabs that I showed you earlier, and basically you want to train your combat stats until your combat level is level 75. There are two options you can do. You can either train your melee stats, or you can train your melee stats and a bit of your range, but this one will take a little bit longer. There are also some pros and cons to this. The pros for training just melee stats is that it will be quicker, but you will obviously need to use a lot more prayer when you're in combat, so I would recommend learning how to pray flick. The pro for the melee and range is that you can use your range to save spot, but it takes longer. It actually takes a day longer to get your stats to this level. If you've chosen the combat route, this is what your stats should look like by the end of day 5. I have based these levels on playing for 6 hours a day for the combat route and 4 hours a day for the mining route. I've done this because the combat route is very AFK, so it's fairly easy to do 6 hours in one day if you've got the time. I've done 4 hours for the mining because mining is very boring and I think 4 hours is more than enough mining for one day. For both routes, I'd recommend doing Gertrude's Cat, and once you've done Gertrude's Cat, I would recommend trying to let your kitten grow up. It takes 3 hours. You also need to feed it every now and again and pet it, but this will save you a lot of time in the long run because normally people leave it and they have to wait 3 hours for it to grow anyway. So if you can, let it grow whilst you don't need it to be grown. And once it's grown, put it into your bank so it doesn't overgrow.
NANI?!
If that makes sense. Day 6, the grind continues. So for this day, you want to carry on mining at Motherlode Mine. Our goal again is to get 100 nuggets. So, you know, the more you get, the better. You want to have at least 60 nuggets by the end of today. If you've chosen the skilling route, your stats should look a bit like this by the end of day 6. If you've chosen the combat route, your stats should look a little bit like this by the end of day 6. Quests you can also do are the Recipe for Disaster Goblin Quest, Nature Spirit, and Fairy Tale Part 1. These are all quests to start getting some farming XP, because later in the bond we are going to start doing farming runs. So, day 7, we should be almost finished with our grind for the skilling route. You should pretty much have 100 nuggets by today. Your stats should look like this if you've chosen the skilling route by the end of day 7. And for the combat route, if you've chosen the melee route, then you should finish your melee grind, your combat grind today. Your stats should look a bit like this. However, if you've chosen the melee and range route, you've probably still got another day to go until you get your stats to where they need to be. By the end of day 7, if you've chosen the ranging route, then this is what your stats should look like. Quests you can do to break up the boredom are fishing contest. You can also get to 22 cooking and then do Forgettable Tale to get some more farming experience. Day 8, this is where the magic starts to happen. If you've chosen the skilling route, then I would recommend that you use the 100 nuggets to get a coal bag. You'll also need to get ice gloves. Now, ice gloves are dropped by the Ice Queen, which I would recommend looking at a guide for, and it is recommended that you have 43 prayer. To get your prayer level to 43, I would buy dragon bones and then use them on a gilded altar. It's going to cost a fair amount of money, about 400k, but it is definitely worth it because then you'll have protect from melee, and you can use that whilst you're killing monsters to negate any damage. Once you have the coal bag and the ice gloves, we can start doing Blast Furnace. Now this is the money maker. This is what we've been working towards. Blast Furnace, making steel bars currently is about 1 mil per hour if you do it tick perfect, but no one is perfect, so I've rated it at 500k per hour. This is your solid money maker. You can do this for what, like 6 or 7 hours, and have made enough for another bond. If you've chosen the combat melee route, you'll be at the right level. You'll be level 75, so I'd recommend doing Monkey Madness so you can get a dragon scimitar. This will be your best in slot weapon until you can use an abyssal whip, so it is very important. If you've got the money, I'd recommend buying the best in slot gear that you can, so like dragon boots, dragon plate legs, a berserker helmet, an obby cape, you know, combat bracelet, glory, all that good stuff. And if you've chosen the melee and range route, you'll probably be finishing up your level grind today. So this is what your stats should look like if you've chosen the skilling route. This is what your stats should look like if you've chosen the melee combat route. And this is what your stats should look like if you've chosen the combat range route by the end of day 8. You can also, if you've got time, do the Grand Garden of Tranquility quest to get some more farming experience and to do a medium Dari task. You can also do Enlightened Journey, and you'll now have the opportunity to complete the Varrok Easy and Medium Dari, which I would recommend, because then you can start collecting your battle staffs and make at least 30 to 60k a day every day. Day 9. So you should be pretty comfortable now, if you've chosen the skill route, that is. You should be able to make quite a lot of money. So now it's just basically doing Blast Furnace until you've got enough money, and then you can go on your own merry way and enjoy the rest of your bond and, you know, prepare for the next one. I would recommend on this day doing quests such as Biohazard, getting the RD Easy Diaries done, working on your farming and doing Ghost Ahoy quest to get the Ectophile. If you've chosen the melee route, then this is where you're going to start doing your Slayer. Now, the reason why we had to get to 75 combat is to use Konar. Konar is a very useful Slayer master. She gives tasks that have the opportunity to drop Brimstone Keys. Now, Brimstone Keys on average are worth 110k each, and sometimes you get 3 to 4 per task. I would definitely recommend, if it's the first time you're doing Slayer, to Google the monster that she is given to you, and also YouTube the best way to kill the monster, because you want to be as efficient as possible. Make sure you bring along the Ancient Mace to keep up your prayer points and to use as little prayer potions as possible, because they are pretty expensive these days. Also, with this combat route, I'd look at doing Ghost Ahoy quest to get the Ectophile. By the end of day 9, if you've chosen the skill route, your stats should look like this. And if you've chosen the combat route, your stats should look a little bit like this. So we're on day 10. If you've chosen this skill and route, you should be, you know, in a pretty good position now. So I'll give you a list of things that I think you should work towards before your bond runs out. You should look at training your combat to whatever level you can. You should look at birdhouse runs. I'll leave a link in the description. There's also Fossil Island, which I'd look at unlocking. I'll leave a link in the description. Some quests that you can look at doing is Tears of Guffix and Fairy Tale Part 2, and also the Kingdom of Miscellanea. I'd start looking at doing farming runs, especially Toad Flax, because they are your best bet to make some profit. You can also look at getting Full Graceful and completing the Ardoin and Lumbridge Medium Diary. I would also look at Recipe for Disaster and starting to get the requirements to complete that. As for combat, you're probably going to want to carry on doing Slayer just to make sure you get enough money for a bond. You've got another 4 days left, so you should have plenty of time. I'd also look at getting into farm runs and doing the Toe Flax herb runs, because that will make you a little bit of money on the side. Also look at doing Tears of Guffix. So this is basically going to be the outro, because I believe that you should be capable of making enough money to secure your next bond now. If not, then you must have done something wrong, or you just must have been very unlucky with the drops. But I'm just going to give you a list of things that I would work towards for both skilling and the combat route, and I'm also going to give you some tips as well as to what to do whilst playing the game to be efficient. So things you want to look at achieving, maybe not in this bond, but you want to start working towards them, is the Fighter Torso. This is probably the best in slot you'll have for a long time. There's also a quest called Animal Magnetism, which will give you an Assembler, which will allow you to train range for free, basically. There's a quest called Temple of Ikov. There's also a mini game called Pest Control, which is quite fun to do, and it unlocks you the Void outfit, which is very useful. I'd also look at getting a Slayer helmet. I'd look into Nightmare Zone to start imbuing some items that you get. There's also an armor called Proselyte Armor, which allows you to pray for a lot longer. It's very useful, saves you a lot of money. If you're unsure about what herbs and seeds to pick up, I would recommend picking up these herbs and seeds: Irits, Qualms, Abentos, Carantines, Ranas, Snapdragons, Toad Flax, and Torstal. These are the most useful herbs and seeds in my opinion. There is also a dragon defender which you can look at obtaining. There is also a holy wrench which will increase your prayer pots by 1 point per dose, which is very useful. Full graceful, as I mentioned, that is a very strong milestone to get. It's very useful. I literally wear it all the time. Fairy tale part 2, so you can unlock the fairy rings. And you want to work towards the recipe of disaster quest to get the Barrow's gloves. That is another big milestone for you to get. I'd be very surprised if you could get this in your first bond, so don't worry if you don't get them, but they are all something to work for. I'm about 4 bonds in and I've got all this stuff, so you are looking a lot further down the line. So I hope this helped with your first bond. I hope you've got some idea of what to do now. I'm very shortly going to start streaming my Dryathlon series. If you don't know what that is, it's where I try to go as dry as possible on a pit. I'm going to start with Giant Mole. The top 10 for dryness on Giant Mole, the number 10 is 7,044, so I'm going to kill at least 7,044 Giant Moles, unless I get, you know, lucky, which I don't want to be, and get the pet before that. If I do get the pet before that, I'm going to drop all the loot that I got from Giant Mole. I will make this drop public, so if you are watching the stream or if you follow me on YouTube, then you'll be able to know when this drop party is happening and where it is going to happen. So I'll hopefully see you guys in the stream or in the next video.